Welcome back to my Painted Anatomy series, the series on which I draw anatomical structures over my own skin. On this video, we'll see a very brief and fundamental view of the thinna eminens, the large muscular bulge we have here, proximal to the thumb. This is a very basic video, so I won't be too concerned about anatomical variations or specific details. If you're interested in that, I have specific videos for each of these muscles in which I go more in depth. The thinna eminens is a large muscular bulge at the hand. When you look at our hand, we can see two large bulges. One of them is proximal to the thumb, the thinna eminens, and the other one is proximal to the fifth finger, the hypothinna eminens. The thinna eminens is the largest of them. It's actually just a group of three muscles that all act upon the thumb. These are short intrinsic muscles of the palmar surface of the hand. They are intrinsic because they are located in the hand and they act upon the hand, on the thumb specifically. So they are located on the same compartment they act upon, therefore intrinsic muscles. They are short because, in many cases, we have short and long muscles, an intrinsic and an extrinsic performing the same function. So we will have, for example, the short flexor of the thumb as well as the long flexor of the thumb. The same applies for the short abductor of the thumb and the long abductor of the thumb. So these in the thinna eminens will be the short ones, and it's not very hard to imagine why. We will have the abductor pollicis brevis, responsible for abducting the first finger, the pollicis, which is the most lateral and superficial of the three. We will have the flexor pollicis brevis, responsible for metacarpophalangeal flexion at the first finger, the most distal and medial of them, and the opponens pollicis muscle, responsible for the opposition movement, that is, bringing together the tip of the thumb with the tip of the other fingers, which is actually a combination of three other movements: carpometacarpal flexion of the first finger, internal rotation of the first finger, and adduction of the first finger. Together, these three movements form the opposition movement, which is the function of the opponens pollicis muscle. The opponens pollicis is the deepest and largest of the three thinna eminens muscles. In some sources, you will also see the adductor pollicis as a fourth muscle of the thinna eminens. However, this is not widely accepted. Like most short muscles of the hand, the thinna muscles will originate from the flexor retinaculum, the large transverse ligament we have above the carpal tunnel, and usually also from the tubercle of some other carpal bone. And they will insert on the thumb, usually somewhere along the lateral, the anterolateral or radial surface of the thumb. This could be, for example, the radial base of the proximal phalanx of the first finger. And they will all be innervated by the recurrent branch of the median nerve, which makes complete sense because the median nerve is the more radial nerve of the palmar surface of the hand, and we are talking about very radial muscles in the hand. Besides, it's the recurrent branch of the median nerve which actually goes over the most distal of the thinna eminens muscles, the flexor pollicis brevis. So right here on the surface of the flexor pollicis brevis, we have the recurrent branch of the median nerve coming to innervate the thinna eminens. They are also supplied blood by the radial artery, which is also very intuitive because the radial artery is right here, very radial and very close to this large muscle mass. Mostly they will be supplied by the superficial palmar branch of the radial artery, which is the branch of the radial artery, which will later connect with the superficial palmar branch of the ulnar artery to form the superficial palmar arch. This makes sense because these are predominantly superficial muscles. After all, we can see them quite easily on our hands. However, there is one exception to it. The flexor pollicis brevis has two heads, a superficial head and a deep head. The deep head is very deep, so it wouldn't make a lot of sense for it to be supplied blood by the superficial palmar branch of the radial artery. So it will actually be supplied blood by deep branches of the radial artery. And we actually have two deep branches of the radial artery right here. One going towards the thumb, the main artery of the thumb or of the pollicis, the princeps pollicis artery, and also a branch of the radial artery towards the index finger, the radialis indicis artery. These deep branches of the radial artery may also contribute to supplying the deepest of the finer eminence muscles, the opponens pollicis. And just as the deep head of the flexor pollicis brevis has a different irrigation, a different blood supply, its innervation is also different. Because it's a deep head, so it's innervated actually by the deep branch of the ulnar nerve. Not completely without sense. The deep head of the flexor pollicis brevis is innervated by the deep branch of the ulnar nerve, contrary to the other muscles of the finer eminence, which are innervated by the recurrent branch of the median nerve. And together, these muscles will achieve abduction, flexion, and opposition. But this is just a brief overview. So, if you want to see a more in-depth analysis of each of these muscles, check my videos on the flexor pollicis brevis, the abductor pollicis brevis, and the opponens pollicis muscles, as well as my Pinch Anatomy playlist as a whole, in which I have many other structures of the upper limb, and so I hope of other parts of the body as well. Thank you for watching this video all the way to the end. Se você fala português, certifique-se de ver também o meu canal em português. And I hope to see you on the next video.